Welcome to Heartfully Creating. Today we are going to look at something that I call painting with polymer clay, transformed from you or ick or whatever to pretty nice. You'll see what I mean. This is my first attempt at a figure. It was a figure that I was planning on making sort of a figurine situation theme to celebrate a dear family member's 50th birthday. This might get boring. I'm recording a lot of this for archival purposes and just for fun for anybody who's curious about the learning process, because I am still learning. This is only my second polymer clay figurine. Here she is before baking. I was aiming for a more realistic type face. Underneath, the armature or foundation is made with aluminum and wire. I already made the 50. She was supposed to be upright and standing. I used rhinestones. Just so you know, they didn't stay. They started falling out with the liquid clay even after I baked it. And then I baked it, cracked it, and whatever. So it's time for attempt number two. It's not looking good. What you see, I didn't be thankful. I didn't save very many pictures of the upcoming other attempts. So, but they're worth looking at to laugh and to learn. And here was the other one, at number three. I gave her away to a little girl who liked her. I told her if she had some clothes to put on her, she could. So I believe she's now named Elizabeth. The party was supposed to be a Gilligan's Island theme. So this little one was supposed to be like a Marianne type image. So there she's in the background, but I had to start number four. Thanks to the idea my husband Craig gave me that maybe she should be like gardening and something to do with 50. So I changed her position and started on the island, or which would be not a whole island, but just part of it that the figurine would be placed on. Again, wire and tin foil for the foundation. And again, a trial and error. So when you're, don't give up, just keep trying. As you can see, I didn't give up, determined to get this done. I had to do extra wrapping of wire and whatnot to secure the base. And then I started adding clay in strips and different colors to create depth. Using your tools really helps to smear out the colors, or blend in the colors. I guess smear is not a very artful word, but that's basically what you're doing. So here's some more images. As you can see, it's palm tree building time. So I just kept adding clay and shaping and texturizing the tree trunk, palm fronds. Later on, right now it looks kind of flat. I started inserting different textures and colors into the trunk, to the sand, the fronds. I also used liquid clay as well as some dry chalk pastels and mica powder and everything, and anything that adds color or texture. This is after it was baked for the first bake for the foundation. It's much easier to bake as you go, because, oh boy, I don't know how people with really long fingernails I see on the internet working with clay do it, but I have very short fingernails and I need to bake it and solidify it so I can keep moving on, or I will be continuously wrecking my pieces. A lot of pictures because I was getting so into it, so I'm sorry that I have a lot of the same stuff and not in between images, but hey, better than nothing. So you can sort of see the transition when you bake the clay. I wanted to make a water effect, so I mixed mica and pastels and actually alcohol ink to create a liquidy, watery look, and added some to my seashells, the coconuts. I texturized. Again, I learned a lot of this from watching the wonderful tutorials that are on YouTube, so check them out, they're endless. And here's my big gold shiny 50 to celebrate my cousin's 50th birthday. And here's some close-ups of detail I just really, I'm a photoholic. I take a lot of pictures, so forgive me that there's so many. But again, this is for archival purposes, so I have a record of this whole wonderful learning event. And here she is. This person is, our image is supposed to represent my cousin. It doesn't look a lot like her, but if you're doing something personal for somebody, even just capturing the essence. I've done this in two dimensions when I make cards. I'm not that great at making something look realistic, but capturing the essence of the person. So say brown hair, brown eyes. And then because of the Gilligan's Island theme, I just added sort of a halter top made out of what would be, say, Gilligan's red and white shirt, some little shorts, and Gilligan's hat, that's supposed to be. And that actually cracked when I baked it in the oven, the hat, unfortunately. But my husband said she's been there on the island for apparently 50 years, so it's okay if it cracked. But I was able to glue it a little bit with E6000. So then I added glaze, and I did keep adding stuff. I wish I would have took some photos in between. I kept adding shells. I attached her by using liquid clay and actually some raw clay shells that I made to really prop her up and help her to stay, and baked it and glaze it. So here's the rest, and I hope you try. If you would try doing a celebratory figurine or anything, I would love to see it. So comment below, subscribe if you'd like to see more. And I'm not sure when I'm going to be doing another figurine, because it did take probably about 3 weeks in total, but it was definitely a work of love. I would never do something like this if I didn't love the person. If you made it to the end, thanks for joining me. And I hope you enjoyed it and hope you learned something. And I hope you're inspired to try creating in whatever medium it is. So comment, ask a question, send a video or a picture of your creation. Visit heartfullycreatingblogspot.com or send an email to that address that just flashed down below. Have a great day. Come again.